morning. My name is Raymond Morse. I'm from South Africa, and we're all stuck in the houses now with Corona. And I thought it was a good idea, perhaps, if people would like to try their hand at sketching. And I thought I'd show you how I do it. I sketch and I paint as well, but I often have a pencil, piece of paper and some other subject that I carry around all the time and do my sketching. So today I'm going to do an elephant. I often do elephants since we live close to the Kruger National Park in South Africa. So animals and elephants and so on are one of my favorite topics. Today we're going to use a book that I found at the Kruger National Park called Kruger Legends. Great Tuskers of the Kruger National Park can be purchased in the Kruger National Park anyway. So let's go ahead. This is an elephant called JOÃO, is one of the big tuskers. So to get the sizings in, I normally use my pencil and work at a distance from the topic. In this case, the elephant on the paper is virtually the same size as there, so I'm just going to basically use the same size. So if you can have a look there, it's more or less going to be from there to there across and down. It's going to be there plus that little piece there, so it's going to be from there to there, it's going to be down from there to around about there. So we just get our sizes. I'm only going to use the pencil at this stage, but I use pencil, pen and ink in many of my sketches. You'll see the elephant has those depressions on top, and then it comes out round with the eyes, another piece that goes in, and then the tusk. So if you're going to have the tusk from the top, is always quite a good measurement. So from the top to the tusk begin, it's going to be around about there, so that gives you an idea of where it will go, and this is about this wide, so something like that. So it's going to go from there to there, and so we could start with the tusks and the trunk, and work our way down. Just to give try and get a basic outline. And work it down, and your trunk is going to end up here somewhere, it looks like. And then from there to there, to that so far, so we can do this. Eyes are going to be more or less there, and take that width is from there to there. So we're working in that area, and so go around like that. And then we can do that, and this is a depression, so it's going to be a little darker, so we can do it in that manner. And these two are going to follow each other, and your eye is going to be in there, and this eye is going to be in there. So I like to do the eyes are very important always, so I normally do the eyes quite quickly. So if you look in there, there's going to be an eye, like that. And it's going to come in there, so it falls down. And then you're going to get this part that holds the tusk in there, and then same this side, it's going to be about the same. So you're going to go like that, and then in, and you're going in there, and that eye is going to be opposite each other, but this one stuck away a little bit, so it's going to be more eyelashes than anything else. And then all around here, of course, inside there, from there to there is going to be your the folds, and they go up and around and down, and so up, around, down, and they differ a little bit. So try and there's little pieces normally inside, and then normally around here they change direction. So if you just follow that a bit, and then it starts flattening out. And in this case, it's got a bit of a turn in it. So you can see this. And then they get smaller as they're going down, or become quite small. And there's always a bit of a fold here. Goes around, and then there's normally a bit of a fold, so somehow we put that fold in, and then the bottom, it's always goes like that, because it has the front part, something like that, because it picks things up with its front of its trunk. Right, we got that. We're trying to, these are normally balanced, so you try and get these things to balance symmetrically. And then normally around the eye is sort of is your last sort of main line that goes across. And so you work it spacings across. And there's always lines coming down, so you have your little lines coming down like that. And they vary a bit, not exactly straight always. And then it falls into the turn and goes down towards the tuck. So it turns and then down, and then right at the bottom there's quite a bit of crisscrossing. And same this side. Turns, comes down, and a lot of little folds in here as it's turning. And a little less down here going down, but they are there to a slight extent. And then always down at the bottom here you get your thick one, so you can turn your pencil that way and make those a little thicker. Like that. And like that. And it gets a little less as you go up. I see there's one up there. And then of course there's always a dark here. You can see it coming across. Lines going across like that. So you just follow the shadows. And because it's curved, the shadows would be going down. So eyes in there, it's going to be dark, but try and leave a little bit of light there. In this case, on the side there's nothing. You can see there's a shadow going across there, and nice and dark here, light there, and of course dark here because it's folded in. Trunk is round, so it would be dark light, light in the middle, or less. Dark there a little bit. Light, yeah, definitely. Lighter as you're going up because your sun's catching in the middle. And nice and dark there. So you can see by doing it that way, it's quick shadows. Then you can just switch it around. Your ears, now the ears, there's always things going across there where your ears go. So it'll go there and then your ears will go back there a bit. You have a piece here and then it comes into there. So it sort of folds in, it never goes straight, it just sort of folds in like that. And this goes up there. And going around there is of course going to be a bit of a shadow. It's going in there. This is round, so the light's going to be in the middle, and it's going to darken up here. Like that. And as it goes around the top, it falls, the light will be on top, and it'll be dark inside. And these sort of meet here at some stage. I'm going around this, around like that, and a little bit of shading over there. Here's always light. This is sort of loose over here, and there's a part that's hard there. So you always get, and then you're always getting folds going up here. So as I go look at, you'll find folds. There'll be folds coming like that. And then and it's obviously going to be very shady there. And he has this little piece there that people go ahead and putting it. Goes in there like that, and then this will be dark, you see, as you're going around there. That's well defined, so the dark's going to be at the back. Yeah, it's going to be light, and these shadows formed by these things are going to be dark. So and yeah, along the edges you'll be catching light again. And inside here is going to be dark. And there'll be folds in here as it folds around. Is around like that, so you're coming in with going around, and then there's that piece there, and the fold always in there. Just like that. And it's going around, so there's always a bit of in and out of shadows like that. And then these are pretty balanced, so your size is going to be more or less the same. So that's going to come there, going to be starting there, and then, as you can see, it's going around there, it's going around there, and in there, and then you'll see there again. There, that's pronounced on this one. And then you're more or less equidistance, you're going, and it comes in here as well. So you're going to, and then it flap ends and it does all sorts of stuff. On that, I think that should become bigger. And then you start the darkening again, yeah. Okay, so you've got your folds again coming. And darkening here. around the eye, and everything will be dark, so the eye stands out. Right to your astral. And nice and dark here. These folds coming in. Your tusks are coming about there, so you get your tusks nicely. And it goes from wider to slightly smaller, like that. And try and balance this one to that one. Lines coming down the tusks. Okay, then we can start putting in the legs. The legs, bum's coming out from there, holding in there. Come like that, and then the legs coming sort of about there, around about here. Legs coming through there, there's it there. And it turns out there and joins the bum. That's the back leg, and then the inside leg is through here. And that's through there. And coming through there somewhere. And it's passing there as well. So it's coming through here. It's got coming at a bit of an angle. And then the foot starts, comes down. And of course, the bottom always splays out. So when you get to there, where you get into the bottom, and get the big feet to the bottom coming through. And this side as well, big feet will start. There's a lot of grass there, so you don't see much. And then this other front leg is coming through here. Okay. On the tusk. Okay. And then its padding starts here. And then coming out, coming back in, something like that. And then the back leg and the body, somewhere there. So the back leg going into there. Right. It's always darker under here because it's under the elephant, right? So you gotta just immediately you can shade that in. All this will be darker. folds in the leg. Just follow them there. And then, of course, this good little toenails, which will be there somewhere. You don't see them in the grass terribly. In this picture, and these folds are always coming down and across. Couple across and couple down. This side the same, there's a couple of veins, and those veins going there and folds going around. You can see over there, there's folds going across. And as it comes down here, it gets a little longer. And then at the bottom here, it flattens out again. Normally. Alright, and then you can, you think we've take out some of the pencil with a touch if you want to. Make it a little whiter. And just use your rubber. Take out. And take out any highlights as well. You can always use the rubber to take out your highlights. You think you've lost some. Right, then you got your basic shape, and then you can now go in and start adding more if you want. And so we'll stop that now and stop it now, and then later perhaps we can go into more finer detail. But that's a nice way to start off a sketch. Thank you very much.